According to the digital economy practice lead at Innovation Village, there is need to eliminate hurdles affecting operations of SMEs, such as access to finance, markets and technology. He was addressing stakeholders from government agencies, industry associations, academia, financial institutions.
So what happens with technology, especially technology moves very fast. Policy is always trailing, and that's an area of friction. You can think about platforms like mobile money. Mobile money, I think, has been in this market for several years before Bank of Uganda came in to regulate it. Now, during that gap, you can find areas of friction, areas of fraud maybe. You have unscrupulous activities. Sometimes it's not about unscrupulous activities. It could be by the time the policymaker catches up, there's already an area of contention.
And SMEs, among others. John Walugembe, the Executive Director of Federation of Small and Medium-Sized Enterprises, stressed the importance of embracing the new digital era to grow sales.
We cannot be there and we're just working for the government. Because why do you start a business? To make a profit. So are you trying to say that we start our businesses so that they're just vehicles for government to collect tax? And this issue of saying bookkeeping, whatnot, these are just academic things. For us who run businesses, we know. USCC, URL, look at the receipt and reject it. Say, why are you rejecting? So you have to fight. So the Federation is going to set up a tax rapid response unit, to support. No.
The micro, small and medium enterprises account for 90% of Uganda's business sector and 75% of the private sector employment. Story by Lucius Kasoma for the news.